narrowly avoided relegation last season, finishing 16th. Sampdoria finished 5th. Game action. Fiorentina's Luca Toni, the strike from the left. Juicy rebound for Stefano Fiore, and he makes it 1-0. Goal in the 13th, beating Francesco Antonioli. And Fiore making his return to Italy after a year in Spain with Valencia. Later, Marcelo Castellini pulling on the shirt of Luca Toni. Toni tried to get away, then decided to make a meal of it. So it's a penalty kick for Fiorentina. Toni makes it 2-0 after 30, 2-0 after 45. Second half now, ball sent in front of the Fiorentina goal. Aimo Diana hits the back of the net, beating Sebastian Frey. Goal in the 74th. Diana's strike took a slight deflection as the keeper stretched out, couldn't reach it. Now 2-1, and it might have gone in off Thomas Ufalusi. Other end, Valery Bojanov with the strike, deflected and off the post and back into play. Ballo, as they say in Italian. The Bulgarian Bojanov with the nice left-footed strike. Fiorentina win this one 2-1 versus Sampdoria. Livorno hosting Lecce. Livorno get it going. Christian Lucarelli with this sweet right-footed strike. He beats Vincenzo Signiano, picking the left-side corner. And this goal in the 12th. Lucarelli scoring a dandy against his former club, and last season Serie A top scorer with 24 gets his first of the season. You see him take a peek at the goal there. Nicely done. Later, Livorno's Jorge Vargas would haul down Suleiman Duyamontene, and the Chilean is given a yellow card for that. 23rd minute, so Lecce sent to the spot. Alex Pinardi beats Marco Amelia, and that goal in the 39th. Ones after halftime. Second half, Livorno. Ball bouncing dangerously for Lecce's liking outside far side. Rafael Palladino, the snipe, high short side. That goal in the 48th. Nice goal by Palladino. Makes it 2-1 as he chases after the bouncing ball. And he goes short side. Nice goal. Nice finish as Livorno wins this one 2-1.
So last weekend, Chelsea.
And reliable AC Milan keeper Nelson Dida counting out the steps in and around his goal before the start of the second half. The pitch was indeed waterlogged. Just under 15 minutes into the second half, free kick Ascoli. The header is stopped by Dida. Rebound Marco Cudini. And he makes it 1-0 as fans at Del Duca Stadium erupt. And it is a dream start for Ascoli. The short cross and the header by Fabio Quagliarella. Stopped by the Brazilian. Cudini scores. Goal in the 56th. But the dream did not last long. In a downpour, Andrei Shevchenko takes it at midfield and goes for goal. The one-hopper low to the right side, beating Fernando Coppola, his first of the season, and he's pumped up. And that's a scary thing when a goal scorer is happy about his first, because he wants more. Look at the water off the ball, and yes, it's a top tenner. Goal in the 62nd as Sheva salvages a point for the Rossoneri in the rain, as coach Carlo Ancelotti looked to have had enough of the rain and not enough of the points. Sono stanco del forte pioggia. That's what he was saying.
Really? Look at him looking around. I'll have the pancakes, please.
Not happy about the rain. You see that look? Luis Figo making his debut, the former Footballer of the Year, playing now with Inter Milan. And unretired Portuguese international signing a 2-year deal early in August for Inter. They took on Treviso. Game action, here's Adriano getting on the end of a Marco Materazzi long bomb. Gets by Stefano Lorenzi. The strike by Samir Handanovic. Goal in the 32nd. And this one is a top tenner. Watch out for the A-train this season. That's what I'm saying. The Brazilian international makes easy work of Lorenzi and picks the short side. Inter with the lead and more to come. 1-0 at halftime. Second half, Dejan Stankovic to cross. Adriano chest then snipes it past the keeper. 2-0 Inter. Two goals for Adriano. Stankovic sends this one in. Adriano takes it in stride, then left foots it nicely. That goal in the 68th. 12 minutes later, David Pizzaro with confidence bringing it into the area. Leaves it for Adriano. Short side, 3-0, goal in the 80th. And that's another TT. Nice finish by Adriano. Good work by Pizzaro. He attracts the attention and he gets his third. Inter secure the victory, and it's a good start for them considering last season they had drawn 11 of their first 13 games. At Stadio Olimpico, 13th place finishers Lazio hosting last season's 7th place club in Messina. Lazio in the light strip, Massimo Oro right to the foot of Goran Pandev. Goal in the 21st. Odo makes this happen with the excellent cross. And look at a drop. Pandev, the Macedonian, scoring 1-0 Lazio. Still in the first, the Sicilian side on the attack. Giuseppe Sculli cuts and has it go. Big save by Angelo Peruzzi. Ball still alive. It's then cleared by Fabio Firmani. Massimo Donati thought his side had a goal, but Sculli strike deflects, and Peruzzi gets a mid on it. 1-0 Lazio. Second half, Firmani with the chip pass. Christian Manfredini rips it at the goal. And what a save by Caglione. A fantastic save. And old Manfredini thought he had one there. The Ivory Coast born and naturalized Italian. He got all of that one. Good save by the keeper from Nembro in Italy. Kept it at 1-0, and that's how it would end. Lazio win at home and are off to a good start last season.